going on, everybody? Welcome to Geeking Poetic Podcast. I am one of your hosts, Larry Roberts. Pickle in the middle here is...
Megan.
And over on the end...
Vito.
Or Ditto, or whatever other name they
whatever get. Whatever it is this week.
Beto.
They get your name. Beto, yeah. All these. Never can get his name right.
Nope.
We are here to talk about one of our current favorite things, which is the show known as...
Picard!
On CBS All Access.
Yeah, and we are on episode, what, four?
Four.
Yeah.
Titled Absolute Candor. So fancy.
It's like us. We're absolutely candor.
What does that even mean? She doesn't know what she's talking
about.
I'm
making shit up.
But yeah, we've been, if you haven't been following us and this is the first time you're here, greetings. We have been watching the show now since it premiered and doing like a little reaction, review kind of thing. At the bottom of the screen, you're going to be able to watch what we are watching with us. You're not going to see the whole episode because then they're going to, you know, get their lawyers after us and all that shit. So
they're not going to get any money from us.
We ain't got nothing to give them, but, you know, that's the way it goes. Anyway, we're going to be watching it and reacting. You're going to be able to react with us as we watch it. We might pause now and then to react to things. And then afterwards, we're just going to talk about what we thought of the episode. And we invite you all to participate by letting us know what you think of the episode. You can let us know what you think of Picard and the show. You can let us know what you think of us. We can only imagine what you have to say about
comments
that.
Disabled.
Oh, yeah, we better disable those old comments. No, we want your comments, so let us know. But with that, are you guys excited? It's been, we had to wait a little extra long.
Yeah, we foobarred the last one. It did not go well.
We thought we were going to watch it last Wednesday, and we all got together at midnight, only to find out it doesn't come on at midnight. It comes on at 2 a.m. in the Midwest.
That's BS right there.
Yeah, so we fucked that up real good. So now here we are, and we're going to talk about episode 4, Absolute Candor. So
do it.
Engage. Oh, we are going to be reacting to some commercials and stuff on here, too. So,
especially if they involve woodchucks.
The woodchuck commercials.
They are the best.
They've been the best, yeah. Hopefully there's more woodchucks.
Oh, the Beta Quadrant.
So every episode has been starting out with like a 14
retro.
Years ago. Yeah, like.
That's awesome.
Flashback, kind of letting us know what resulted in all this, you know, like a little bit by bit.
I'm going to cut my hair like that in the point.
Start going to Misfits concerts and shit. Do you have any idea how much we'd make fucking fun of you if you ever had a Romulan haircut? Just saying. Just for future reference.
Okay. His little baby Romulan ears. They're just a little pointy. Let
me see. All of a sudden he pulls out a phaser.
You're dead, bitch. Bang, you're dead.
Damn it.
Too fucking bad, kid.
Wait till he gets older.
And then he pops lots of bones. It's so good of you to
have taken him in. What is it you have? So is this going to be the samurai guy?
I think that's pretty obvious, yeah.
I think it's sweet seeing Picard with kids because he normally doesn't like kids.
Right.
You know?
We saw in the trailer last week about that they were going to introduce that young warrior Romulan. I'm sure that's who that's supposed to be. All kind of still tying together the whole what happened that day sort of thing with the sentiment, what do you call him?
Synthetics,
yeah. Attacking Mars and all that, but we still have absolutely no idea why that happened.
It said Jerry Ryan, so we're going to be at 7 to 9.
Oh, is that what it said, Jerry Ryan?
It did.
Oh, I missed that.
And this is the first one produced by Jonathan Frakes, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes, that is true, so. We'll see how the quality is compared to the previous
last couple
three episodes. Because I thought they've all been good.
Yeah.
But I know that the episodes that Frakes did for Discovery, people were saying were like some of the best ones.
Really?
So. Oh, no more commercials. We get right into it.
Fucking awesome.
Yeah. He's going to be like, shut the fuck up already.
All you have on board is Klingon opera.
She's like the new Data. Shut the fuck up.
Here's my dad.
He's like, I wasn't looking to have a fucking conversation with you anyway.
Where the hell are we going?
Bitch talks a lot of shit.
Fucking hospitality holograms.
Jeez. Not a lot of hospitality in this episode so far.
Another F-bomb. The idea of going
there. I would say more...
bitchy?
For real?
I'm going to be straight with you.
Oh, well, that will make a refreshing change. Come.
Told her.
Is this a secret meeting? JL wants to hire an assassin.
They are not assassins. JL. You can't hire them. The
Kowak-Malat. Yeah, have not to only choose. Has she got a bad attitude, but she keeps calling him fucking JL. And can guess what, folks? Thing?
We ain't
don't like it.
No.
Right?
New. No.
And it so runs us. Entirely counter to everything.
See? Absolute candor.
How we feel about the fucking one broad.
Resume.
Jia.
Who?
So he's on like this rescue mission, but he has to make a pit stop.
The way of absolute candor sounds potentially annoying.
Anybody else think that all of them are kind of annoying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She did. Allison Pill didn't sound this annoying in the other episodes for some reason to me. Did she?
No.
Okay.
Different writer for the different episodes. Well, that looks fucked up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a PlayStation 1 character or something. Man.
Just fucking staring at you. All of a sudden she's like, yeah!
God, those sun flares, dude. Jesus.
Oh, well. Still an Abrams show.
A cash gift is always appropriate.
Fuck, we don't have cash. Yeah.
I thought somebody was stuck in a transporter loop.
Me too.
The fuck you staring at?
Yeah.
Oh, we love the woodchuck commercials. That was perfect.
Now, was she in that video she was watching? It was like before she lost her
mind?
Yeah,
it was supposed to be
before. Got it.
And I think that was pre-Borg assimilation as well, it looked like.
Well, that's usually what happens when people look at you. You're seen.
I
want
to show you something.
My penis.
Yeah, I'm just gonna say, he's gonna. I think she's seen that a couple times already.
Point to penis.
Where are we going?
A Borg ritual with shoes on. Why do I not picture Borg like running around barefoot?
You're like part Japanese and shit. Somersault through there.
Oh, this is fucking dumb, dude.
What is even happening right now?
I'm so confused.
That's well, that real was corny as shit. Yeah.
That's a real reason I told you to take those shoes off.
Easier to get the pants off now.
Yeah.
Dude, you know he's emotional. You should have given him something emotional. Jesus.
Yeah. He was a touchy-ass kid.
Touchy-ass now.
Yeah.
Next window opens in 7 minutes.
He's going to be best friends with what's-her-face with the curly hair, I bet
right.
you.
Yeah. Fucking told you. Like, bitch, fuck your sign. Oh, he steps on it and shit.
Some balls right there, Jesus.
Look at the fucking face on that one, don't you?
Put it back, she ain't done yet. Damn. Oh.
Oh, oh yeah, dude!
I regret your choice. This boy.
Yes, ma'am.
He says understood.
is our Picard.
Right.
I swear.
Open the book.
Dr.
Jurati. Hands together.
Open the book.
Close the book. Round the fence.
Is that sister being all creepy?
Yeah.
Sure is.
Mm-hmm. It's like pig nosed.
Then later. Now we fast forward and she comes busting and she's like, it's been 1 week since you got the seed.
That's Cantor. Near miss.
Vito, space battle.
Yep.
That old peeps targeting system is primitive, but the planetary security net worries me.
Is that another?
Looks like it.
He's got hologram for every aspect of the ship.
That's awesome.
She's like, whatever, I don't fuck.
Oh no.
Oh god. All right, well, that was the end of episode 4 of Star Trek Picard. So, just right off the bat, first thoughts. What are you guys thinking?
First half of the episode was a little weird and goofy for me.
Yeah.
But then it turned itself around, and I really, really, really enjoyed the second half of it.
Yeah,
I think I'm with Vito there. Yeah. First half is a little weird. Well, the beginning was good. The middle got a little, I don't know. And the end was kick ass.
Yeah.
I liked the episode. I thought all this stuff with, not Elrond, Elrond Hubbard. What's his name? Elnor. Yeah. Thought that's all pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I mean, a little drawn out at points, but we needed that. Obviously, we needed that backstory. I'm not feeling right now. I'm sure it'll get better. I'm not feeling the whole thing with Romulan boy and Soji
robot
or whatever.
Robot chick
and Romulan
Nemark
boy.
Nemark or what's his name?
I'm not feeling it. I think the acting's good. I don't have a problem with the characters. I feel like the story development there with the two of them went like nowhere in this episode. I mean, like that whole bit, I get that it was supposed to be, he was trying to like loosen her up or whatever, but the whole thing with the sock sliding down the Borg hallway and stuff.
That was dumb as shit, man.
I was like,
to give you my absolute candor, that was dumb as shit.
Right? I mean, it felt out of place and it didn't, there's no point to it, you know? Oh, well, you know, they're in love, but oh no, you know, she doesn't trust him and he's shady. I mean, like, man, you've been establishing that since, fuck, the first episode. We're now, like, almost halfway through the season. I don't know. I just hope there'd be a little bit more development, I guess, in that area. Or they shouldn't even have bothered with them. You know what I mean? In this episode. Like, they should have just
focused. It added nothing to this episode. So, yeah, I could see that.
Right. So that's my only real criticism of it. What about you?
No, I agree with you. I agree with you.
Yeah.
I have nothing new.
But you enjoyed it.
I enjoyed it, yeah. It's just that, like you said, that one sock scene. I was like, give me a break.
Yeah, that's pretty
seriously, cool. Break something on me so I don't have to listen to watch this anymore.
But otherwise, I mean, yeah, now more bringing the crew together. We've got Elnor. We've got, of course, the big thing in this episode that lasted all of 30 seconds was we have 7 of 9 back. She comes in and saves the day at the end, which was awesome. I didn't think that ship looked shitty. I thought that ship
was amazing.
Yeah,
I thought that was pretty cool. I mean, as it is, you know, they're right on a ship that looks straight up out of Buck Rogers of the 25th century, you know, Gil Gerard, like 1979 shit, which I like because I love that stuff, but I'm looking at it going, that's a straight up a Buck Rogers shit, man. Yeah, I mean, there's not a whole, I wish there was more to comment about. There's some good violence there, man. That dude getting beheaded.
That was crazy. That was some fucking ghost ship. The first scene of Ghost Ship right there, man.
All the green blood just spewing out.
Yeah, I don't know if we've ever seen anything quite that graphic on Trek
I haven't seen
before.
That, yeah, or in a horror film in like probably 10 or 15 years, a decapitation like that.
Like a
in
like
that
a,
style.
In anyway. That style, yeah. Not in a good horror movie.
Yeah. Anyway.
It's cool. I wish there was more to comment about in this one, but I feel
I think
like
we're still building the story. I think this whole season is going to be building the story.
I guess. I hope not.
The last episode. Last 30 seconds.
And now we saw in the, yeah, and then we saw, speaking of the last 30 seconds, we saw the trailer for the next episode that it's going to get into, now we're getting into a traditional Trek trope, say that five times, where they're going to have to get dressed up in some sort of
fit in
garb to go fit into wherever they're going to go. This could be fun.
It could be fun.
Or it could be dumb.
It could easily be dumb.
We shall find out.
I'm leaning towards the side of fun, though, because I do have fun in some of those episodes. Mm-hmm. Next gen, anyway, not so much the original series, but...
I just wonder... We'll see. I'm going to be very curious to see how it... Because that sort of stuff works in next gen. But this isn't next gen,
right?
Man. Like, this is a completely different tone. It's a more serious, darker kind of tone, so... Goofy is not going to play quite the same,
which
man.
Is why that sock debacle.
Yeah, that's, yeah.
Did not work.
Yeah.
That wouldn't have worked next gen either. That's
No, it wouldn't have.
We've had worse things in next gen than that, but it just didn't make sense. I was like, okay, where are they going with this? And I you know, just so that he could kiss her and then say something that makes her think like, oh, he's shady after all. Like, that was already established.
Drinking and she thought that. Like, right. Are you following me?
Right, exactly. And then he's basically kind of like proving that, like, yeah, I'm following you. What, bitch? And
you should have just kept your mouth shut, dude. You would have been fine. Like, that's the rule in a relationship. Just shut your mouth, get what you need, and then you can move on, right? I mean, that's.
Wow.
Vito's relationship rules.
It's a veto tip right there.
There's a veto tip for you. It's been a while since we've had a veto tip. Whether you're a Romulan.
Shut your trap.
Yeah, whether you're a Romulan or a Klingon or a human or a Tellarite or whatever you are. If you're dating,
you talk too much, you fuck it up all the time, man. That's
yeah. Whether your chick is actually a human or she's just some robot chick, just keep your mouth shut, get what you want, and get the fuck out of there. Right? That was Vito's tip.
There you go.
And that's one to grow on. All right. On that note, I don't think there's anything more we can say about this. Decent episode. I'd give it like a B, maybe. I think I'd give it like a B if I was grading it, you know.
B minus, maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah, I go with a B minus. All just because the second half saved it for me.
Yeah.
If that second half didn't happen, then yeah, it would probably be a C minus, I think.
C plus. Yeah. Yeah, B minus. Okay, down with that. All right, so this is a B minus. And it's directed by Jonathan Frakes. We love us some Jonathan Frakes. But
I don't think it's the best one yet.
No. Nope, definitely not the best episode yet. So let's see what episode 5 holds for us. So we will be back probably in a week or less with episode 5. We like our fives. On that note, no, wait.
Yeah, what is that funky one? Oh, there you go.
Oh, the book, open the book.
Is it the
clap
steeple?
Your hands, open the book, close the book, throw it the fuck out. Bye, everybody.
See ya.